But there shouldn't be stalls in men's bathrooms and bars in the first place. Because who the fuck is pooping at the bar? You're gonna poop at the bar? You're gonna poop here. Steve, you're gonna poop at the bar. The bar that we're at, you're gonna poop at this bar? You feel okay with that as a person? Pooping at the bar. Okay, now I know who you really are. Pooping at the, who are your friends? Who's your family? Go home, you animal. What are you? You pig person, poop at the bar? Out of your mind? You're gross. You're a gross human. You don't poop at the bar. You man up if you have to poop. You man up if you have to poop. You finish your drink, pinch it off, and you walk home so you can poop at the house naked like a grown-up. Like a full-grown adult. If you're pooping at the bar that I'm at, and I see you doing that, I'm gonna walk in, look under, walk out, and go, hey, this guy pooping here wearing blue Adidas. Blue Adidas, yeah, he's pooping right now. And then leave you with your mistake. How's everybody looking at my shoes? Because you pooped here, Mike. What's wrong with you? Get your life locked up. Pig. Go home, you pig. Say that next time you see someone pooping in a bathroom, walk in and go, go home, you pig. Make me sick. I'm a guy who recently, thankfully, found a woman who was dumb enough to stick around. Stupid girl. Stupid girl. Because look at this, you know? Like, look at guys. You're gross. Why would they even go for us? Why would a woman want to do stuff with you? You're gross. You're disgusting. Look at a naked woman. Take one look at a naked woman, right? Beautiful, symmetrical, hairless. What a creature. Whatever made it, finely crafted it, like a Ferrari, you know? Ooh, took time with it. And then they got to the guy, and they were like, we ran out of time. Just, no, put the genitals on the outside. It doesn't matter. No one's gonna see. Who cares? Hair? Throw some hair on it. Fine, throw some hair on it. It's phenomenal. Every day, what do we fool? We fooled you. Like, we should wake up, guys, and just be like, tricked them. We tricked them again. Got away with murder. I don't know how we ever convinced you to do anything in the first place. Kiss me where I pee? Kiss me where I pee? How? You know that place that you breathe and eat from? I stuff my dick in there. Can I clog up your source of life with some flesh? Life, the life hole. Can I just cork it? I want to cork it. I want to cork your life hole with my body. How on earth did you say yes? Cork it? It's a remarkable thing when you think about it. Like, how do we ever even start this sexual chemistry to even get to that level of doing stuff? Here you go. A guy can go to a bar. Single guy goes to a bar trying to pick up chicks. He can go out there and mumble around. I want to put my body in your body. That's all he's saying. Baseline level. I want to put my body in your body. Can we do that? You sound debonair at the bar. You're like, oh, well, I work for an investment firm downtown. But what you're really saying is like, and I put my body in your body. And like, I put my body inside of your body. That's all it is. You're not that cool. You're just trying to put some of your body in someone's body. You got a gap. I got a wedge. Can we do the thing with the thing and the thing? That's it. Think about that. That's a hard thing to do, to go out to a bar and convince a girl, I'm the guy that you want to do things with. Think about how hard it was for us to start that. How did we start that? How did a caveman ever get to that point with a cave woman? How did a caveman say that when there was no language, no communication skills? First of all, when you were a caveman, you just stood around with your buddies, mumbling. You're like, That's it. There's really nothing going on, just a lot of. And one of you, out of nowhere, would just get an erection. Explain that to the crew.
Oh, come on, so, oh, oh, hey, oh, go, oh, oh, no, no.
All your buddies are mad.
Hey, bitch, I'm out, no.
They don't like it, pointing at them. You gotta be a nonverbal dick salesman going up to women like, hey, come on, say goodbye, hey, goodbye. What are you selling? She doesn't know, you can't say it. Who said yes? The slowest girl in the pack. Had a bad leg, she was lugging around.
Okay, okay, okay.
How did that happen? The guy that convinced a girl to do that for the first time invented fire in the wheel that afternoon. It was like, everything clicked.
I got it.
Everything made sense. I would have loved to see the first caveman that discovered pulling out. That would have been amazing. All right, the first guy that's like, oh, 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 oh. That's where all that shit on the wall got started. They were like, oh, oh, blah, blah, blah. What do you think, that ink? There was no ink. It's jizz symbols. It was a big debate. Gender-neutral bathrooms. And I'm all for it. Bathrooms are bathrooms. I don't give a shit who uses my bathroom after me. Use it. You gotta go? Go ahead. Use the bathroom, man. It's a good thing. For years, I was sick and tired of going to a bar and seeing girls cut the bathroom line when theirs are too long. They walk to the guys and they go, hi, our line's too long. Do you think me, can we cut? Is this chill if we cut? I know this is a stereotypical impression. I don't give a shit. That's real. Can we cut? That's real. And every asshole in line is like, go ahead. Also real. Also real. Also a real impression of us. You go like that, we go like that, okay?
Yeah.
So guys, let them in. I'm tired of that shit, because we can't use your bathrooms. Guys can't use girls' bathrooms at bars. You can use ours. Why can't we use yours? The only thing I ever hear is, well, you pee on the seat. Do we? I don't. I don't pee on the seat. If you live with someone that pees on the seat, it's because they hate your fucking guts. They're sending you a message. Why don't you get the groceries, Karen, you fucking bitch, you fucking asshole. He's saying something to you. That's between you two. What do you think? You think we walk in the bathroom, we just open it up and let it go, and it's like, ah, wherever it goes, it goes. I know where it goes. I got a laser pointer. I know precisely where it goes. Right there. Pee on the seat. That's amazing. It's ridiculous. So that's, to me, I think the fix has always been remove the stalls from men's bathrooms in bars. Remove them. Urinals, or just holes in the ground. It doesn't really matter. Guys will pee into anything. We don't really give a shit. But get the stalls out of men's bathrooms and bars because they shouldn't be there in the first place, okay? They should never have been there because a girl can't walk in now and use a urinal. Unless you can, ladies, and then I want to see it. If you can tippy-toe pee, I would love to see it. I don't know if it's this way or that way. I don't know which way is better. But if you can do that, I want to check it out. I grew up here in downtown Chicago for half of my life in Chicago, and the second half we moved to the western suburbs, right? We moved to the suburbs because my sister was born, and my parents were like, I'm not gonna fuck up two of them. We can't do that. One's good. We'll fuck up one. That's okay. But we moved to the western suburbs, you know, and to try to better the life of all of us. But, like, I still realize sometimes how, like, my mom used to fuck with us subtly. Like, my mom is crazy. She's a crazy person in the best way. But she would, like, lay it in real slow. Like, my parents were somewhat religious, right? You know, I mean, Irish Catholic, kind of. You know what I mean? Like, you, like, it, somewhat in, you know what I mean? You're like, in the hot tub, maybe. But she used to do this thing. She used to make me say every single night before I went to bed, now I lay me down to sleep. Do you know that? Does anybody know that? I used to have to say this. Like, I used to have to repeat this. I'd say, now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. And if I die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. I would say that before bed, which is a really fucked up thing for a child to say out loud. If I die before I wake up, I'm six. I'm gonna die in the middle of the night. And God's gonna leave my body, take my soul, but be like, body's good. Leave the body. It's fine. Leave it. What's going on? Crazy person. I love her. She's the best in the world. I had Irish Catholic guilt. I had so much Irish Catholic guilt when I was a kid. I used to flip a coin to determine whether or not I was going to masturbate that day. Huh? You think I'm kidding? I would take a quarter. I would go, heads, yes, tails, no. I'd flip it. I get tails, and I go, ah, best two out of three. We got to go again. Let's see what happens. He didn't beat me. Never won. That's how heavy my guilt was. Seriously, that's how, like, in my head I was about that God is watching you type of stuff. Like, my mother used to let us not lock the doors. She was against that. She's like, you don't lock the doors inside of the house. If you're locking the doors inside of the house, it means you're doing something you shouldn't be doing. Yeah. That's why we lock the doors. Don't come in here. I'm pulling on my body. Get out of here. Leave me alone, lady. That's how I realized the guy that invented locks inside of a house must have been caught masturbating by his wife one too many times. Was sick of it. He was sick of it. He's like, you know what? That's it. I'm gonna put locks inside the house. She's like, Michael, what are you doing? We have locks on the outside of the house to keep criminals from coming inside. There's no criminals inside of this house. Yes, there are, Karen. And they're robbing me of my freedom. Let me pull on my body in peace. I live now in Los Angeles in a neighborhood called West Hollywood. West Hollywood is a gay neighborhood. It's kind of like up here. It's like where we are right now, Boys Town. I like the gay neighborhood. The gay neighborhood is the best neighborhood I've ever lived in my life. It's safe. It's beautiful. I love it. I love it. You get in where you fit in, and I fit in that neighborhood, okay? I'm not gay, Dad, but I'm down to live around gay people. They keep it clean and safe. I've never been attacked once in my neighborhood. And by the way, if I did get attacked, I would love to be attacked. What a beautiful way to walk home. A guy leaps out of a bush. Where are you going? Where are you going? Where? Where? Huh? Gives me outfit tips. They can fly, you know? I have a lot of gay friends because of that. They're people just like you and me. There's nothing different. There's nothing different about that neighborhood. It's cleaner and safer, and I fucking love it. The only difference is I got a big beard. I've had a big beard. I got to keep a big beard for a while. And that's okay. And gay guys love guys with beards. Why? I don't know. It's a thing. It's an underbelly thing. It's on the internet. Look it up. But I often get hit on. I get hit on a lot. Okay? I get hit on way more in the gay community than the straight community. And I'm okay with that. It's a confidence booster, fellas. It feels nice. But I've lived in a gay neighborhood for so long that now I'm picky about what gay guy hits on me. A gay guy hollers at me and I'm like, all right, you couldn't handle it, dude. You couldn't handle it. Too tight, too tight. Keep walking, man. Pinch you right off. Get up out of here, man. Couldn't have it. If I had a superpower right now, you know, I wouldn't be to, like, fly or be invisible. I would love to be able to throw acne on somebody. Right? He's all, fuck you. I'm like, fuck me, dog. Fuck you, dude. No! Had to hit him all over the body. Shoulder, back knee, hit him with the back knee, hit him with the knackney, that knee acne. Light him up. Light him up. Scar him physically and emotionally. Send him home like that for a couple of weeks, depending on the topical cream. Let it sit. Let it sit. You're not laughing at that. You didn't have acne when you were a kid. I had really bad acne when I was a kid, man. It was so bad. It was so bad. Like, acne is like the sole reason I question God. I'm like, what up, dude? What's the deal? Where are you at on this one, player? This is ridiculous. Here you are, 13, 14 years old. You're the ugliest version of yourself. Look at photos of you at 14. TBT, I'm on Instagram, and you're like, woof, tough looking kid. You're ugly, bro. You are ugly at 14. Teenagers are so gross to look at, hard to see. They're hard to see, bro. They're skinny, their voices are crackling. They're wobbling all over like little skinny baby giraffes, just hungry and horny, like, nasty looking creep. They look like Tim Burton cartoons. They're barely alive. You are nasty as a child. And you're telling me at this vulnerable point in your life, God is gonna be like, you know what? I'm gonna put some red pus bumps on his face. And pus bump his face up. I didn't get it, I didn't understand. I had it so bad I had to go on Accutane. You used to have to sign a form that said, I can die from this medication. What's up, guys? What are we saying? I can die from this medication? I can die from this medication. And I was underage, so I had a legal guardian, so my mother had to sign it. I was 16. I'll never forget. They slipped the sheet to my mother, and she looked at it, and then she looked at me. Yeah, this is, it's better than your face, okay? Doesn't really matter. You're an ugly kid. You're ugly. You're gonna do this. It's for you. I had it so bad. I had acne so bad when I was young. When I was in high school, I played basketball for a couple years at my high school until I found out about drugs, and I was like, see you later, basketball. true story. But I played basketball for a little while. When I played basketball, I made the JV team pretty early on, and we played in a summer league, okay? In the summer league, you had to play all the other schools that you were going to play in that regular season. And I'll never forget, we went out to West Aurora to go play these guys, and they were supposed to beat us. They were like a really good school, right? They were really good. They were an all-black school. We were a some black school. They were gonna beat us. Bottom line, they were gonna win. And we went out there, and we beat the shit out of these guys. I had the game of my life. I dropped 4 points. I was on fire. If you know anything about high school basketball, 4 points is like, whoa, what are you, MVP? Final score, 12-2. It was a blowout. So anyway, we went out there. I had a great game. I was on cloud nine. I felt like a king. And I left, and I went out to the hallway to go get a drink of water. I'm getting a drink of water, bending down by the water fountain, having a drink of water. A little black kid, like 8 years old, walks in the hallway, comes up to me and goes, hey, yo, white boy. White boy. I go, what's up? Pretty good, man. Oh, thanks, man. He goes, full white boy. And I was still like, thank you. I appreciate that. I'll take it. And he goes, all right, man. I go, all right, man. He walks away. Felt good. Go down and get some more water. He gets to the doorway. He stops. Real Forrest Whitaker style. Turns around and goes, hey, you white boy. I said, what's up, man? What up? He goes, what the fuck is all over your face? That still hurts today. I'm in my 30s. That cut went all the way to the bone. You know what I mean? And I walked up to him slowly and I said, well, this is what happens when your dad sticks around. No, I didn't say that. It's a joke, man. No. I called him the N-word and I got out of there as fast as I could. No, stop it. I cried on the bus, man. I cried on the bus. Black people always accepted me. Black people really did. White people never liked me. White people don't like redheads. For some reason, there's this thing. White people see redheads And they're like, what do we do with it? They don't like us. They don't trust us. They make a day to kick us. They call us names. You fire crotch. You ginger. They ask us stupid questions like, is a carpet match your dreams? A black guy's never said that to me. White guy's like, carpet match your dreams, bud. And I'm always like, are you a grown-up asking about my penis hair? Is that the level that you're on? You're worried about my penis hair, dude? And if you must know, it's hardwood floors. There's no carpet there, bro. I cleaned it up. We'll get you a little buzzer from Target and clean that shit up. You get under there and it's like, it's working overtime under there. That's a no-fly zone. No-fly zone. You might die under there like, I can't. Anyway, I love being from this city. And now I live in Los Angeles, California. I live on the other side of this great country. I like it out there. It's okay. It's a second home for me. It takes some getting used to. It's a little bit difficult. But the big difference is like, when I come back home, you know, like, all my mom wants to do is talk about, like, the weather. Like, that's a big thing. My mom is like, how's the weather in California? Is it nice like this? It's like, yeah, it's better than this. That's why I'm out there. What are you talking about? It's always better. It is. There's a lot of stuff that isn't better, but the weather's always going to be better. And she loves bringing up the feels like meter. You know what that is? The news guy. The news guy's like, it's 62. Feels like 68. That's Midwest hope. That's hope. Circulating in your body. That's the greatest lie ever told. Who's the feels like guy? I want that job. If that's a job, I want it tonight. I'll drop this bullshit gig and go do that tonight. The feels like guy, greatest gig ever. Here in the studio, it's 62 on the barometer. We're gonna go live to Andrew Santino. Andrew, what does it feel like? How's it going, news team? Like 67, right back to you guys. Right back to you guys, man. It's nice, really nice out. It's crazy, man, because the weather here fluctuates so much. Like, when I come back, you're never surprised. Like, you're never surprised by anything in Chicago. But, like, who I feel bad for when I come back is the homeless people. I always feel bad for homeless here, man. Like, I don't feel bad for homeless people in L.A. People can get mad at me for saying that. I don't give a shit. They're awful human beings, these L.A. homeless people. They're terrible. They're terrible people. I feel bad for Chicago homeless, right? Because they die in the winter and they die in the summer. They're never not dying. They're always dying. It's like a week when it's like, we might make it. And that's it. And they bucket drum their way through that week. It's the soldiers, man. So I feel bad for homeless people in Chicago from my heart, because this is my home. So when I come home, I give money. I gave money today to a homeless guy. I'm not lying. I gave money to a homeless guy because I feel bad for him. I know what he's got to go through. I gave that money to that guy, right? And I'll always do that. But I also want to look him in the eye and go, hey, start walking south. You have nothing to do tomorrow. What are you doing here? You have something on your calendar? You don't have a calendar. You can air fist fight dragons all over this great country. I'm sure there's half-smoked cigarettes strewn across this great land. I mean, the wind is their therapist. That's all over the place. They can move about, man. You know the birds? You know those things? You know those guys? When they leave, follow those guys. Birds are born instinctively knowing when it gets cold to be like, let's get the fuck out of here. It's cold. Let's leave. This is ridiculous. Why are we here? This is ridiculous. But I don't feel bad for homeless people in Los Angeles at all. I really don't. I don't feel bad for them. Some people are like, oh, that's kind of mean. I don't give a shit. I don't give a shit because I live amongst these people and they're rude. They're rude. You know why they're rude? Because they made it. They're at the promised land. It's 72 degrees outside. You know what it is inside my place? 72. Who pays for that? I do. Fuck those guys. They won the lottery. They sleep on the beach. I came out of a restaurant, right? I came out of a restaurant when I first moved there. I had no money. I had zero money. Came out of a restaurant, had some leftovers, went up to a homeless guy, said, hey, sir, I got some leftovers. Would you like this? Okay? I'm on a date in front of a lady. Would you like this, sir? And the homeless guy looks up at me and he says, what's in it? And I looked at him and I said, tomorrow. Another day on this earth. What are you, gluten-free? Eat the food. Cock-blocking me, man. I'm trying to smash a five. Help me out. What are you doing? Why are you doing this? Times are tough. Who are you? I did so much white people shit in Costa Rica. It was bananas. I loved it, though. I love being a tourist. Like, that's the fucked up thing about Americans. We don't want to be tourists. Why not? Why are we so afraid of being tourists? I'll do that zip line dork-ass shit. Give me the helmet. I love that. How much is the picture? $1,000? I don't give a shit. Pay for that? Plan for it. Come on, man. Give me that dork tourist shit. We're so afraid as Americans to be tourists. Yet, for some reason, tourists come here. They're not afraid to be tourists. You can go to Michigan Avenue right now. There's a cute little Italian couple that's like, excuse me, scusi, mi scusi. Go to the water tower. And you're like, ah, come here, let me lie to you. Come here. Get on to the thing. Let them be tourists, man. Be a tourist. All I'm saying is stop being such a liar. Be who you really are. You're out of the country. Be out of the country, man. There's nothing wrong with that, you know? Here's why. Every time I've ever been to a Spanish-speaking country, there's always one guy in the crew, one dude, who's like, hey, I got us. I can take us around. I speak a little bit of Mexican. We're going to be good. We'll be good. You speak Mexican, Brett? I speak Mexican, dog. I got us. Don't sweat it, man. Took 101 in high school. We're going to be straight. You're like, all right, man, I can't wait. You walk into a restaurant, I say the truth. I walk in, I go, hello, American, Americano, American, ready to be ripped off. Look at me. Because I don't give a shit. How much is that Coke? 7? Thought it was 10. You can't fuck me. You can't fuck me. I planned for that. You cannot fuck me. But he walks in, Brad walks in, talking Mexican, like, hola, seniors. Hola, seniors. Beep, 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 beep. Beep, 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 beep. Ba, 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 ba. He thinks he's the shit. Brad walks in heavy. And the staff looks at him like, okay. Habla español, señor. Habla español. Sí, señores. Sí, señores. Habla español. Habla español. And they're all like, okay, Good. That's good. And they just machine gun Spanish at his fucking head until you see him go, oh, fuck. There's no biblioteca in there. Where's the banjo? I don't know any of those words. Brad looks like an asshole. Meanwhile, I'm enjoying my plate of rice and polo, having a great time. Enjoying my life. You got to be careful of social cues. Social cues mean a lot, right? And guys are stupid. Men are stupid. We're stupid people by nature. We're just dumb. We don't give a shit, by the way, when girls are like, men are dumb. Who cares? Well, I don't care. You think I care? You think I'm dumb? I don't give a shit. I know I'm dumb. It feels really good. Try going out your day without talking about a relationship. That's what you guys do all day. It's like, I heard he was with the bed and she was that. But like, and we just walk around like, it's great. It's fantastic. I don't worry about shit. Makes my day so much easier. But guys are idiots, and I'm proud to be an idiot. But social cues amongst men are interesting because you got to be careful what you do in my neighborhood, right? Like in my neighborhood, it's a little bit different. Because when I walk down the street and I see another guy, right? I do this thing. If I see you and I walk down the street, right? We pass each other and I go like this, what do you do? If I go like, yeah, you dude me right back, right? You dude me right back. He dudes me. We dude it. Hey, dude it. We dude it. Do we know why we dude? No. Zero clue. We walk around like pigeons all day, like, hey. They don't give a shit. I do it to black guys to show them that I'm not a pussy. I go, hey, what's up? We good? We're good? Good with a black guy. Okay, some fight breaks out. We're good. We got a black guy. We're good. We got one. We're good. We're good. We got him. I have no idea why we do that. We share genitalia. There's no other reason that we do that to one another. But you can't do that in my neighborhood because it means something totally different. And it hurts. It hurts a lot.